various aspects of African culture will go on display this weekend at an event dubbed African Heritage Night. Students of the American University of St. Vincent will host the event at the Peace Memorial Hall this weekend as part of Emancipation Month activities. Coordinator of the event, Mishimori Rikizito, said the idea is to display the African culture to the Vincentian public. Mr. Rikizito says persons attending the event will be given a first-hand impression of life in Africa. The event begins at 6 p.m. this Saturday at the Memorial Hall. The National Emergency Management Organization, NEMO, continues to host a wide range of programs to ensure that everyone is adequately trained in disaster management preparedness. Deputy Director of NEMO, Michelle Forbes, said several successful community disaster management meetings were held during the month of July, including 6 meetings in different communities in relation to volcanic eruptions. She said that the meetings are part of the organization's annual public sensitization campaign. Residents and visitors to one of the United States of America's most affluent tourist destinations, Martha's Vineyard, will on August 27th experience a taste of Vincentian culture. The Vineyard Gazette reported that the latest initiative between St. Vincent and the Grenadines and Martha's Vineyard, Vineyard Vinci Fest 2016, will feature visual arts, performing arts, and food from both islands. SVG Consulate General to the USA, Selman Walters, and Dukes County Manager Martina Thornton are working closely to put together a celebration of differences and similarities in Vineyard and St. Vincent culture. Mr. Walters told NBC Radio that a mandate was given to the Center for Enterprise Development Corporation to help local persons who are desirous of having their produce displayed at the event. He said one of the highlights of the event is a raffle which one lucky patron stands to win a trip to SVG with accommodation sponsored by Beachcombers Hotel. Nephrologist Dr. Tawana Brown Caesar is urging persons to be mindful of their sodium consumption as it could negatively impact their health. Dr. Brown Caesar, a doctor who specializes in kidney care and treating diseases of kidney, was discussing the topic, the effects of excess salt on the body, during NBC's Views on Issues program last Sunday. She explained that while the use of salt is necessary for some conditions, it is the excess use of any product high in sodium that is of major concern. Dr. Brown Caesar said persons suffering from hypertension must limit their sodium intake. The St. Vincent and the Grenadines Medical Association is planning to set up an oncology treatment center here. President of the association, Dr. Roslyn Brown Ambrose, at the launch of the Project Pink SVG, disclosed that the Medical Association wants to set up an oncology treatment center, beginning initially with chemotherapy administration and management. Dr. Ambrose said this venture is expensive. For that reason, the association is in the process of seeking cheaper cancer drugs. Project Pink SVG is a charity organization which will be providing support for patients with various forms of cancer in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Science Initiative for Environmental Conservation and Education, the Forestry Department and the Mustique Charitable Trust will host two sets of science summer camps under the theme Biodiversity, We Live It, We Learn It for children between 7 and 12 years of age. The first, already in progress, will end on August 12th, while the second will run from August 15th to the 26th. Coordinator Listra Kozak said the program will cater for 35 children. Ms. Kozak noted the Junior Scientist program, slated for September, will come out of the summer program. The National Lotteries Authority hosted a media conference on Tuesday, August 2nd, unveiling its new website, www.nslsvg.com, and new service, the Lottery app. Product Development Officer Anthony Denny says persons could now be able to source information about the products and services of the National Lotteries Authority on their smart devices. CIBC First Caribbean says its new mobile banking app for smartphones, which was launched 2 months ago, has proven a big hit with thousands of customers of the regional bank with a 4.8 rating in app stores. Trevor Torres, Managing Director of Customer Relation Management and Strategy, announced a major update to the app, which now allows CIBC First Caribbean credit card holders to monitor their credit card rewards points. The new app, which can be downloaded from the Play Store, the Apple Store, and the BlackBerry, is accessed via Android, Apple, BlackBerry, and Windows devices. It affords users the convenience of checking their account balances, transferring funds, paying bills, and locating branches and instant tellers, all from their mobile device. Coming up next, we take a look at the sporting highlights.